Good evening. So let me express my gratitude here for you all to be here and help me with this topic here, which is quite, let's say, not here, but it's like a philosophy, right? This question here, I can ask to each one of you about this question. I can assure that each one of you will give me different answers because we are different ones. We are individuals. So we have different experiences. We've got different thinking. We are different, right? But let's try to put this concept into a generic one. And the idea here is to make you reflect on what is going on with you, right? That's the idea here. Who are we? Who are we? And who will we be? We are talking about past. That's the beauty of the Spiritism. When we talk about Spiritism, it makes sense that we are coming from a past life. We are running into a current life. And in the future, we are going to have additional lives, right? It's a continuous way to improve ourselves, right? So let me bring the first challenge. So we all want to be in this way right here, right? Going up. That's our objective. We do not want to go down. And I can assure you that we are going up, right? And you can see the other picture here. I would challenge, who is going to build the steps for us to go up? The tip is over there. Is there anyone that can answer here? Who is building the steps? Ourselves. Yeah, we are the constructor of our stairs, right? It's a good thing because we do not depend to any other people, just on us. That's what we are going to reflect here. Make sense here? Let's improve the warm-up. References for today. Look at that. A lot of references we have. In English, the Spirit's book, the basics of the Spirit doctrine, right? The gospel according to Spiritism, it's how we can bring the divine laws closer to the gospel. On the Way to the Light, it's a pretty nice book, very short, it's not so big. I recommend you to read this book. It presents a logical flow from our existence here in the planet, on the planet Earth, since the beginning until nowadays. It's a pretty interesting book. Evolution in Two Worlds, in the realms of mediumship, they are very technical. So if you like to go deeper in the studies about how we communicate with spirits, how we can make our own evolution, I'm saying spiritual evolution, not only here, but as a spirit. And another book right here is a self-discovery, which is very important to answer the questions, right? It's a basic concept that we need to understand ourselves. Then we become able to answer the three questions that were presented in the previous slide. Okay, let's start here a warm-up for us to disconnect completely from the outside now. Let's bring you all inside and let's hear this music here and then we make a short reflection on this.
Life was so wonderful, a miracle.
A few knows this music, but I'm not sure if you perceive the lyrics here, right? Does any one of you has the same questions as the Supertramp here? Right? Look at that. Won't you please tell me what I've learned? Sometimes we ask that, right? What I learned about that. I know it sounds absurd. Please tell me who I am. So let's see if at the end of this reflection, we can help Supertramp to answer this question. That's the idea, right? At least for us, right? We are simple men. Let's try to help him and to help us to answer this question. Okay? Are we in? Let's start. First question of the day. Question 784. From the Spirit's book. Look at that. This was written in 1857, about almost 170 years ago. Humankind's perversity is very great. We feel that thing, right? We feel that. Doesn't it seem like humans are regressing instead of progressing, at least from a moral point of view? It's a pretty updated question. It's valid for today. What is the answer? What is the answer? Just think about it. Can someone say the answer here? What do you think? What do you think? Are we regressing or are we improving? Come on, guess. Good guy, improving. Exactly. Look at that. You're mistaken. Observe the whole closely. If you think about 150, 200 years ago, slavery was pretty common. Right now, we cannot support slavery. Right? We're improving. Women, 200 years ago, was almost a second class. Right? Now we are improving in terms of society, morally. Observe the whole closely and you see that they are advancing because they have a better understanding of what evil is, leading them day by day to reform their abuses. The excess of evil, look at that one. The excess of evil will make them understand the need for good and for reforms. That's exactly what we are facing now, right? This answer was provided by the spirits, that they know what's going on. They know what's happening around us, right? And we are going better and better and better. That's what we are going to prove today as well. So let's start with the big picture. So in this book right here that I presented, right, On the Way to the Light. So if we can, I think it's better, yeah. We can see here Jesus, right? And our beautiful planet there. So this beautiful planet, from a fireball, it turns into a beautiful planet, right, that we know today. This is about, what, 4.5 billion years ago. Too much time. So can you imagine something that happened in 4.5 billion years ago from that situation to here, just by coincidence? Just by lucky? There's no sense for me. So when someone talked to me, that's my opinion on that. So the Big Bang, boom, a huge explosion that generates the universe and so on. That's the theory, right? So for me to contradict that thing is that go to a place where you've got a lot of iron, right? Junk cars there, explode. And try to find a Mercedes after that. It will never happen. If there is no intelligence behind that. There is an intelligence here. From there to here. And the intelligence is God. And Jesus is the governor on that thing. Since 4.5 billion years ago. It's amazing. And now, today, we cannot make a cake. We've got the receipt for a cake. Us. We are not capable to do a cake sometimes. Jesus and God worked together 4.5 billion years ago and created that thing, right? It's not coincidence. Absolutely, it's not coincidence. If you put that thing into some kind of physics and mathematics, the probability for this thing to happen is almost zero. To not say zero. It's 0.00000000 to happen that way. So there's no coincidence here. There is an intelligence behind who creates that thing. And we are right here, right? We start to incarnate on Earth at this level here. Before the sink, there's no human incarnation. So we start right here to incarnate as a human being until today. Sounds good? We are on? Okay. Why this is important? Because of this thing. Now let's see the earth. So we saw the question that I presented, that we are going up, right? So Kardec, in the chapter 3, item 4 of the Gospel According to Spiritism, he presented to us this evolution of the worlds, every world in the universe, right? It's not only the earth. So we are going up from a primitive world until a divine world. So to go in this direction is depending on us only. So we are helping God. We are co-creators. Right? We are co-creators of that thing. So we are going from primitive world until divine. A primitive world is the first incarnations of human souls. Spirits, human spirits, start to incarnate it. Right? Then we start to become a society, to become more intelligent, to become more socialized, and with moral practices. Then we move up to proofs and atonements planet. That's the current situation of planet Earth. We are exactly at the end of the proof and atonements and going to a regenerated planet, which is better than before, right? And we are going to continue to move up. How long does it take for this transition? It depends on us. Only on us. Right? If we improve ourselves, I'm saying improve, not only intellectual, but moral aspects. We are going up, going up, going up, going up. If we are not capable to follow this evolution, what happened? God will find a place for you in another planet, right? It's like you are in school. If you cannot follow your friends, probably you're going to change to a school that will be a little bit adequate to your kind of behavior. It's the same here, right? Make sense? It's what we are seeing here. So if you go back 2,000 years, if you go back 10,000 years, if you go back 100,000 years, that's what we are moving up. In 1,000 years, 2,000 years, probably we're going to be here. Probably. But it depends on us. Right? So from the Spiritism books, we know that we are in the transition from here to here. Probably we are midway here. Closer to here. Okay? So that's the psychosphere, planet Earth. So now let's see the spirit hierarchy, how we can help the Earth to move on. That's exactly by this hierarchy that Kardec classified in the questions 100 and 113 of the Spirit's book. We started with imperfect spirits, close to a caveman. Then the second order of spirits, the good spirits. The third order, pure spirits, very elevated. Right? So like Jesus and so, pretty high. Where are we here? Where are we here? Guess, come on. What? Third one, right?
Yeah.
Third order. So for me, when I start to read Spiritism and so, I was very frustrated because when I saw the scale, I think I was a good spirit because I'm not doing anything bad to others. And then when I start to read, I perceive that I'm very imperfect spirit. I need to improve a lot to reach a top level, right? So, but the way that we are going up, a good news here is that there's no way back. There is no way back. This curve here is always going up. Maybe a little bit slower, maybe a little bit faster, depending on us. Right? It's only depending on us. Don't count on others to push you up. Others can help you, but not bring you up. It's only depending on us. which is good, right? It's just our effort. Good here? If we move up, we help the Earth to move up as well. In the planet's classification. Okay, who are we now? Let's understand the concept of the integral man. So we are physical body, flesh and bones, right? We are the perispirit, which is a semi-material that integrates the physical body and the energy. The energy is the spirit, right? Spirit or soul, synonyms. In the spiritism, we treat spirit as the incarnate, the discarnated soul. When you are incarnated, it's a soul. But usually we talk spirits, it doesn't matter, okay? So in the question 141, Kardec brought that thing to us. This is not like an onion. It's not tears, right? It's an overlap. So we've got the physical body, we've got the perispirit, and the spirit. Okay? It's only this? It's only this? Yes or no? It's only no. What we have? We have another concept here. It was brought in the Evolution into Worlds by André Luiz. We call the vital body. It's like the battery that we receive when we incarnate. So if we use the battery in a good way, the battery will last longer. If we don't use the battery in a good way, the battery will, okay, will go down and gone. So when we discarnate, these two here, out, okay? The double etheric or vital body, out. Physical body, back to ashes, right? So what remains? The perispirit and the spirit. That's what the mediums, when the medium has the capability to see spirits, what the medium actually sees is the perispirit. Okay? It's only this? Of course not. We've got the mental body. The mental body, it's exactly from the spirit how to shape the perispirit. So the spirit is present to us when we discarnate. What happened to the perispirit? Usually you become younger. Good news, right? Good news, become younger, because our mental body is capable to see ourselves as a younger than we actually are, right? But on the other way, if you got a bad concept of you, your mental body will transform you to a different one, right? So when we discarnate, we've got just the mental body, the spirit, and the spirit. Make sense? Overlapping. It's not tears, it's all overlap, all bundle here in this body. Okay? That's the concept of the integral man. Whatever you do here in the physical body will impact here, the vital body, will impact the perispirit and the spirit, and the mental body as well. The same way, your emotions are in the spirit. Whatever you do there, it will reflect here. And the medicine is proving that thing, right? You can't cure by yourself. There's a lot of proofs in the medicine books and so saying that only because of your mind, you change your mindset, you cure yourself for a very bad disease. It's proven. So that's the integral man here. Who are we? We are here. Okay? Any questions here? Good? Are we good? Okay. So now I prove to you who are we. But for us to improve, we need to go to the process of reborn, reincarnation, right? Jesus presented that thing to Nicodemus when he was talking to him. He presented that for you to reach the reign of God, you need to reborn. Reborn means exactly that. We make a plan. We make a plan here with our mentors when we are on the other side, the spirit side. So our perispirit is diminished. And then we born again. And then we grow as a kid, young, die, and then back again. So whatever we do here will impact our spirit. So when we incarnate, we receive, like I say, a forgiveness. Okay, whatever you did in the past, forget about that. Let's start. But your experience are all in your spirit. Then you know what is right, what is wrong, internally. Just ask your mind, am I doing wrong? Am I doing right? Right? For example, I can give $1 million here. You found $1 million in the street. So if you are not a theft, you're going to get this $1 million and give to the police or to someone. If you're in the not so good, you're going to get a thing you put in the pocket. Right? So that's a self-knowledge. So, but let's see how the spirits explain to us why we need to reincarnate. How can a soul who did not reach perfection, us, by the way, welcome to the club, during its corporeal life complete the work of its purification by submitting the trial of a new existence? So it's like you're going to school. You're going to receive some tests, some atonements here, to see that you are, okay, I learned the lesson. Remember the question from Supertramp? Please tell me what I've learned. We learn it. It's here. It's in our mind. How does the soul accomplish this new existence? Through its transformation as a spirit. Look at that. Look at the answer here. In order to purify itself, the soul, of course, undergoes a transformation. That's the reason we are going up, right? But for this to occur, it needs the trial of a corporeal life. It's like you practice and then you know, go to an exam. So the corporeal life is the exam that we need to prove that we are adherent to the moral laws, if I can summarize. Makes sense here, the logic of incarnation, the need for incarnation, right? And the beauty of the incarnation, that's the God's justice. How can you prove God's justice without reincarnation? I can't. And I can tell you a short story. I think most of you knows Steve Jobs, right? Most of you know Steve Jobs. Steve Jobs, he was a very religious guy in the 60s. He was going to the church almost every day. It's in his biography, by the way, the story. And he went to the Sunday school at the church. And then on his way to the church, he stopped at a newsstand and saw the Newsweek, the magazine, Newsweek. And in the cover of the Newsweek, it was a poor young boy in Africa. Very skinny, very depressive situation, right? So what he did, he bought this magazine and went to the church and asked to the prayer, right, at the church, if God knows everything. So the answer from the priest was, yes, God knows everything. Then Steve Jobs get the magazine and present to him. Does God knows this thing? How can you explain that thing without the reincarnation? How can you explain God's justice in a kid in Africa, maybe 2-3 years old, skinny, hungry? After that thing, Steve Jobs became atheist because the priest didn't give him an answer. The answer is here. For every incarnation, we need to go to a new experience, to a new trial, to see if we are strong enough to move up in the in our spirit evolution, right? Okay? Let's move on. So when we incarnate, we can classify three types of deeds and efforts that we are going to be presented: proof, atonement, and mission, right? Let's see what is proof. Proof is when you encounter a new experience. Let's say I was incarnating as a man, and then I incarnated in the next one as a woman. I never incarnated as a man before. So when I incarnated as a woman, it's a new experience for me. It's going to be a proof. Maternity, for example. You were never a mom before, and now in this one you become a mom. So if it's a new experience, it's a proof. Atonement. Atonement is that, okay, I made mistakes. We all made mistakes, right? I'm saying moral mistakes. When we incarnate, those mistakes or the situation that caused that mistake will be presented to you again to see if you are okay with that, right? It's like you have failed and you need to recover. And the mission. The mission is when you come to support others. As an example, Jesus came as an example, right? He came in a mission. I can give some others that came to here as a mission to present them as an example and to help others to improve, right? Maternity is one example. Maternity, we can fit maternity in any one of them. Maternity can be a proof if it's a new experience. Maternity can be an atonement. If, for example, we fail in a previous life as a mom or as a dad, right? And could be a mission. You incarnate to bring someone and to help someone to move up. So that's the way that we are gonna be presented in our life. So think about yourself. What are the sufferings? What are the trials that you have in yourself? And maybe you can identify what kind of good deeds and effort you face it. Okay? Let's see one thing. That's a good guy, right? Remember him? I'm a spirit with a high mileage. And I remember this type of cartoon. I love it. I don't know why Hanna-Barbera is over, because it's a fantastic series, right? Yogi Bear, Hair Bear Bunch, what else? Flintstones, Hanna-Barbera, nice. So this one, for example, how do we act when we face some kind of a trial or atonement? Do we face like this guy here? Do you know the name? Can someone remember the name? No. Who is this guy here? Who?
Scooby-Doo.
No, this is not Scooby-Doo.
No, I just know what he said. He said, oh dear.
You're going to see
everything
here.
Went wrong.
This is Hardy Har-Har. Friend of Lippy the Lion. Right? So let's see here. There's a sound. Hold on.
Oh my, we'll never see land again, Lippy.
Oh, shucks, Hardy. Stop your worry, Wharton.
Hold on.
Hey, there's an island.
Let me go back here. Just a second. I'm so sorry.
Out ahead.
Oh, it's...
So...
Oh, dear. Oh, my. We'll never see land again, Lippy.
Oh, shucks, Hardy. Stop your worry, Wharton. Hey, there's an island dead ahead.
Oh, it's probably infested with hostile natives. Oh, dear. Oh, my.
So, I think most of us face something like that, right? Sometimes we are a little bit hardy, right? It's gonna be tough, oh dear, oh. And also there's another one that maybe some of you remember. It's a small one, that's Woody Allen. Woody Allen is one of the most pessimists in the world. And he published on, I think it's on a weekly basis, about the Diary of a Pessimist. And the Diary of a Pessimist, look at that, expect for the worst. Whatever comes is a profit. It's very pessimist. So how do we face atonements and approval on a daily basis, like Hardy, like Woody Allen? Or do we face like Waze, Google Maps? Why Waze and Google Maps? Look at that. Waze and Google Maps, when you put a direction to go, right? If you make a mistake, what happened? He does not blame anyone. He just fixes. Maybe it will take a little bit longer, but you're going to move on. That's the way we should think, right? You make a mistake or so, okay, let's fix and move on. Instead of staying like Hardy, or instead of staying like Woody Allen. Okay? And how can we, what is the powerful tool that we have, that God gave to us on this? Positive thinking. Right? Positive thinking, prayer. Positive thinking is the tool that we have in our pocket at any time to face a difficult situation, approve or atonement. Right? It's free. It's free. It's just use. Positive thinking. Instead of blaming like Hardy, do that thing. And what Paul taught us. Look at this simple phrase here. God is with us, right? No questions about that. God is not playing against us. I proved to you, look at the evolution, and so God is with us. If God is for us, who can be against us? No one can be against us. So that's what Paul brought to us, right? When you think a little bit down, just remember this phrase from Paul. If God is for us, who is going to be against us? And repeat to remember that. And then your mindset will change to a positive thinking. So a good thing is that we can learn from the spirits, right? That's a good topic. The spirits taught us about this. This book right here is one of the books written by Kardec, Heaven and Hell, where he presents a lot of conversations with spirits, talking, how are you, what are you facing? And look at what they presented to us. I brought here three spirits. A happy one, which is the way that we would like to be happy, right? An average spirit, most of us, and a suffering one. Look at what they have in common, what they are talking. The first one congratulates himself for not having lost time. So practice the good, improve. But don't wait something, improve, improve, and improve. So the happy spirit, I didn't waste my time. The average spirit, his regret of not having better used the time there on earth. And look at the suffering spirit. I need to repair the time I lost if I do not want to extend the suffering. So time is the key. Don't waste our time. Time is key. Right? So don't wait. Don't postpone. So that's what the experience from them. They said, I waste my time. So for us to not blame like them when we are going to be on the other side, let's prove to you in terms of math. If you don't like math, I'm trying to simplify here what I just said about time. Mathematically speaking, 1 is the neutral element of multiplication, right? So if we do nothing in 100 days, which means that we are not going to improve. It's going to be 1 elevated to 100. At the end, we are going to be 1, the same. The same. If we improve just 1% a day, 1% a day, how many minutes it is? Less than 15 minutes. Less than 15 minutes. Look at that. If we improve 1% a day, in 100 days, we are going to be almost 3 times better. 3 times better. And you know how much it will be in a year? 36 times better. So that's the importance of time. I'm just saying 15 minutes. And look at what the spirits told us. Spirits books question 909. Are an individual's own efforts enough to vanquish his or her bad tendencies? Look at the answer. Yes. A very small effort is often all that is needed. It is the will that it's missing. We don't have the will to do something. So we are lazy. We are still imperfect on that thing. It's quite astounding how few of you make any serious effort. The spirits are. Look to that. It's a small effort that we need to do on a daily basis. It's an exercise. Improve yourself morally, right? Do good for others. Just 15 minutes. Look at that. So nothing, right, to do. Absolutely small effort. Okay? How can we do good? How can we be good? Kardec also presented the features of a moral person. That's something that I would suggest. If you got to take a shot, put in your pocket. So those are the rules for a moral person. How we can improve with a little effort. Practice is the law of justice, love, and charity. Not difficult, right? Small effort to do that thing. Does good for the sake of good without expecting any retribution. Do it for free. Just do it. Kind, humanitarian, and benevolent towards everyone. No distinction. No distinction. Because he or she sees brothers as in all mankind. So under the same father, the same fatherhood. He or she is indulgent towards other people's weakness. So that's charity. I'm just talking about charity. And Paul brought to us, right? Kardec also brought, without charity, there's no salvation. So just put this paper in your pocket and remember when you need something to remind you how to improve. He or she is not vindictive and practice forgiveness. Charity again. Right? And the last one, respect others' all rights. The laws of nature granted them. So my limit is limited by the other's right. Period. So simple, right? Is it difficult to put in practice? Difficult? Or it's a short effort? It's the will, right? It's the will to do. Difficult? It depends, right? So, frankly speaking, we are not going to become saints in one incarnation. Don't try to, I'm going to be the... At the end of the incarnation, I am a saint. No, let's not be... let's not create some kind of false expectation. But we can do good, right? It's a small effort. Small effort. Okay? Can we answer, Supertramp? Who are we? If we evaluate ourselves, if we do a self-analysis, a self-assessment on us, right? Using a self-knowledge, we know what we were, who we were. If I was a bad guy, if I am a bad guy now, probably I was worse, right? In the previous life. So that's the point. We are very curious about on what I was and who am I in a previous life? Why you need that information? Why do you need this information now? I prove to you that we are in an improving curve, which means that we are at the best in our evolution, right? So you need to know what you did in the past. You were worse than here. You don't need that thing. So, but if you are so curious, study yourself and try to see what are your defects and your virtues, right? Then you know what you were. Who are we? Once again, verify your self-knowledge. Understand yourself. Identify your weakness. Identify your potentials. Then you know who you are. And the understanding of integral man. Whatever you think about the spirit will impact your body. That will impact your perispirit, the vital body, and the mental body. Right? If you understand this concept, you know who you are. And in the future, who will we be? Depending on our spirituality. Depending on us to improve. Right? If you don't improve, you're going to stay the same. Are you expecting different? So if you want to do something different, you need to make it different. Right? It's proportionate to our efforts in doing good. Right? I just presented the paper there. If you do good, you're going to be a good person in the future. And it's also, that's the toughest part. It's proportionate to our efforts in accepting and overcoming ourselves. Accepting ourselves, it's a difficult exercise. It's a tough exercise. Because sometimes we are not capable on forgiving someone. It's tough, right? It's tough. But we need to do this effort on that. Okay? Can we answer Supertramp? Or not? We can help him, right? We can help him. Okay. So let's see here this message here. At the end, we are looking for happiness, right? We are looking for happiness. We are going to improve, but looking for happiness. Our next step will be a good spirit. We are imperfect spirits. We are going to be a good spirit. What does the happiness of good spirits consist of? Look at this message here. In knowing all things. In feeling no hatred, jealousy, envy, ambition, or any of the passions that make people unhappy. Does any of you think about hatred, jealousy, envy, ambition? So, proves to us that we are not a good spirit. The love that unites them is a source of supreme happiness. Love each other the same way that I love you. That's the message from Jesus, right? They do not experience the needs, suffering, or anxieties of material life. Look at that, beautiful. Imagine if you do not experience needs, sufferings, or anxieties. And look at the end. They are happy with the good they do. Period. Doing good is the message for us to who we'll be, right? There's another story about John Evangelist. John Evangelist was the last apostle who died. He passed away, I think, with more than 100 years. That's what the history books presented. And he usually was invited to bring some lectures to present the word in the churches, initial churches of the Christianism. And every time he was invited to promote this lecture, he was giving just a short message. Love each other. And one of the churches, when he presented just this short message, love each other, bye-bye. When he presented, someone raised a hand and said, so you live with Jesus, you talk to him, you learned a lot. You are just telling us this short message. Yes, that's the first lesson. If you don't know this lesson, you cannot move to the upcoming lesson. So that's the message here. So I appreciate your attention. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Peace for all. Thank you.